Hello, this is James from X Robots or Coyote K, and today we're going to be taking a real quick look at the Underground Toys Transtemporal Sonic Screwdriver. And before I begin on that, today I am wearing these Reebok sweatpants. Yes, these are really comfy and really nice for when you're on the jog. So yeah, I'm going to be taking a real quick look at the Underground Toys Doctor Who Transtemporal Sonic Screwdriver. Now, this is episode 2 of my unprofessional toy reviews, and real quick, if you didn't get that reference, I highly recommend you go and check out the channel in the description below. It's called James Burton. He is a really awesome guy. He makes some epic stuff. I highly recommend you go check him out. He is awesome. And that being said, let's go and get on with the toy review. So, real quick look at the packaging. You can see that we have this sort of nice little diorama here on the side of the exact same thing in the window. And of course here we got the little Doctor Who logo, and yeah, that's unclear. It says what you obviously couldn't see that. So, compatible with the personalized your own Sonic screwdriver set. So if you don't really like the way that this looks, then I suppose you can go and just go and get the personalize your own Sonic screwdriver set, and then just make your own. So yeah, and as you can see here, it comes with 8 new sound effects. It is property of BBC and Underground Toys. And on the back here, there is actually a storyline that goes along with this. I'll go and read it out to you because you can't see crap with this camera. With the TARDIS trapped on Earth in the transtemporal state, the Doctor finds himself at the center of 4 time zones. As with each previous time zone, the TARDIS generates a new sonic screwdriver for the Doctor. But this time, it is created in the style of each time zone. Elizabethan, Victorian, present day, and future London. With additional new features, including a wood setting, that's good, the Doctor must try to free the TARDIS before time runs out. As with every other story, once again, compatible with the personalized Sonic screwdriver set, and of course, the instructions are on the side, but for some reason, mine ended up with an instruction manual inside as well. So that's enough about the packaging. Let's get on. Oh wait, not yet. Not just yet. Hold on, it's on. In the back here, we also have this nice little blue vortex. Yeah, you can see that pretty clearly, can't you? Yeah, this sorry about ocean vortex. This reminds me a lot of the ocean, doesn't it? And I really wish this was used in series 7 of Doctor Who. Instead of that crappy vortex. Oh man, we don't speak of that anymore. Yeah, so as you can see, it is held in this very secure little diorama thing here, and it is really hard to get these things out. Really hard. You kind of have to pop them out and cause the plastic to get all weak and shriveled and blah. So assembling these is fairly simple, since it's already done. I don't really have to do this, but I'll do it anyway for you. As you can see, let me go and show you that. Yeah, I should probably do detailing afterwards. Okay, so basically, what you want to do is you go ahead and line up this little sort of reader thing with the button, and then slide it into place, and it slots in like that. And then, of course, you want to take your little boiler and go ahead and put it in, and then twist it until it clicks into place like this. Okay? And then next, of course, you get your little switch area, and then align it with this really hard to see. You can see that, right? There's like a little chip on the ring section, but you want to line up your little button here with that, and twists until, once again, locks into place. And then this one is a little bit louder with the locking mechanism, of course. You want to go ahead and have these little tube things here line up with the two crystals, and then, of course, twist until it clicks. Like so. And now you have your own little sonic screwdriver. Now, features. Well, not features, but detail. Details. If we go along here, you can clearly see that this sonic screwdriver is sort of a 10th and 11th Doctor amalgamation in the fact that it has the blue emitter, but the shape, of course, is the booger. You know. Mom! Anyway. okay, yeah, so, moving on to detail, moving on to detail, we have, like, this nice little rust effect on each of these, as well as this little gold pattern to which actually reminds me a lot of the, River Song Sonic Screwdriver. Have you guys ever seen that? You probably don't even know what Doctor Who is, which sucks, but, I'm alone in this world. Anyway, they've got these nice little rust effects on them, which I really like. And, moving on slightly upward, you can see we got this little cargo section, and on both sides we have these little bolts, to which, of course, hold things in place. Now, moving on to the, Victorian era, you can see that we got this nice little sort of pattern here. And, of course, we got this little sort of gauge thing here. I don't know what that is. And on each side, we have these little crystals. And, of course, the button thing is to blend in, of course, with this. And here is future London, to which is very, very plain. I don't know. I don't know whether or not I like it. I mean, as a whole, this sonic screwdriver does look good, but I don't know. As you can see, both ends have sort of silver, along with this sort of power thing, I guess. And on the back, we have this little speaker grills, which is kind of obvious, but it's concealed enough. And of course, we got just plain white, of course, and not much to talk about. And moving on down here, we have this lovely little boiler. I'm going to try and do as much justice as I can to this. Holy crap. Just one second. I want to try and get like a flashlight or something so I can shine it better on there, and then you'll be able to see it. Alright, hold on. Never mind. Let's hope that you guys can see that. Yeah, so we got this nice little detailing here on, like, whether it be these little bolts or the lovely little design of almost like water or grease getting burnt onto the sides. I mean, I can see it's just fine. You guys suck and you can't see anything. Moving on here, we have this little knob section right here. Yeah, you can see that just fine. You got this little knob section as well as sort of weird windy thing. This little tube to which would obviously burn your hand. So that's lovely. So that's about it for detail. Overall, it is extraordinary. It is splendid. And now, here is the features. Now, real quick. By the way, there's like a little bit of tape here, and then the only reason why there is because the one that I got ended up having a bit of an issue, but I fixed it up with a little bit of tape. Everything's fixed with tape in my world. Yeah, moving on to features, of course, if you click this little button in here, it'll emit sound effects. First sound effect is, of course, your standard buzzing. Wrong. Now, here's where it loses points for me, because here's the second one. As you can hear, it is, I guess, the wood setting. If I were to guess, that'd be the wood setting, which I really think should have been one of the hidden sound effects. I think that it should have had two regular buzzing noises. That way, people could just go. Sorry, go around. Yep, it's definitely paint. Instead of, no, it's wrong. No. Hold on. Retake. Yeah, and let's go ahead and have a listen to the sound effect, the hidden sound effects. Of course, there's like 8 little clicks that you do. So here's the first one. Second. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What's nice though is that the emitter actually blinks a lot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That one's slightly different. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah. So, it's got a wide range of sound effects, but some of them sound a little bit similar, so you think, so it kind of makes you think like you haven't pressed the button enough or something. At least that's how it happened for me. I don't know if you guys have good enough hearing, or if you don't have brain damage. I don't actually have brain damage, yeah, but sure it's hard to tell that I don't. So, yeah. What are you looking at me like that for? Anyway, yeah, so overall, this is a really good Sonic screwdriver. I highly recommend you go pick it up, even if it is on eBay, and I don't care how much it is, you go pick it up right now. And as well as the Build Your Own Sonic Screwdriver set, I haven't actually bought that yet. But this was really a snatch for me because it was the last one, and there were a ton of watchers on it. I had to get it. And the only thing I find a little bit weird, it's not necessarily an issue, it's just a little weird. If you see here, you can see if those are like the little power button thing, of course. And this is the same, of course. I mean, I'm not mad about that. Why would I be? It's not false advertising, but I'm not mad at anything. It's a little bit weird because the toy review that I watched on this had Gallifreyan symbols on this little sticker thing here, which of course was Stephen McCullough, or as he used to be called, VoteSaxon07. And I'll put a link in the description of his channel as well. May as well. Yeah, but his was different from mine, and I don't know if this is either a newer version or what. Yeah. I got a different one. So, yeah. That was the Sonic screwdriver that I just got. I really do like this thing, I think it's awesome. So, yeah. Really do pick it up, and it was only like 20 something for me. But then again, I live in Texas, so. Yeah, it's free shipping too. Anyway, I'm rambling. So, until next time, this is Sean's Legacy. Signing off. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye.